Ciao comrades, today I'll be showing you how to play PS Vita games on Android, be it phone, tablet or smart TV. So let's get into it. First, required specifications. As you can see, for Android they are here. The higher specs the better, clearly. However, Vita3k is not as demanding. As you can see, this device has 4 gigs of RAM and it's like a weaker chip, Unisoc Tiger T618, and plenty games are playable. For example, here I'm playing a Dragon's Crown. And it's, as you can see, it's run almost full speed, you know, 60, 57, 55, and this is not even the latest version of Vita3k. I still haven't updated it and the performance is still quite solid. Here I just want to remind you that there is no official iOS Vita3k emulator. Here we are on their official website and these are the only 4 builds available right now in June 2024. Windows, macOS, Linux and Android. That's all. In case you come across some video that claims this is how to play PS Vita on your iOS and it's not from Mr. Sujano, then it's most likely a scam. All you need for this procedure is your phone connected to the Wi-Fi. Then you need to go to Vita3k Android at GitHub, link down below, and you download the latest release, which is now 12. So we click on it. It's gonna be downloaded. Yes, we wanna download it. It is done. You cannot find this application on the Play Store, so the only way is to go to GitHub. Preferably GitHub, because there is the, you know, you got certainty that there is no malware or anything built into it. Whereas with the other sites, it's a bit more complicated. So we click on it. If it's gonna say something like this, for your security is not allowed, go to, you know, settings, allow. Go back and install, then open. Now we are greeted with this, so we press English United Kingdom, next, current emulator path, yeah, we're gonna leave it like it is. Now we're gonna download firmware and font package, so download firmware, click, internet, decline, download update, we are on this website, download update. If it's not gonna download, you just click on it, hold, and then save link. I think it might not do nothing now. Yeah, it's not doing anything, so we need to press, hold, and save link. Can be downloaded securely. Allow. Yes, we wanna freaking allow it, bro. What do you think we're trying to do in here? Okay, it's downloading, you can see. psvupdate.pup. Then we go back. And we download font package, internet. The other one started to download automatically, so now we wait until they are both downloaded. Both have downloaded successfully. Now we go back to emulator. Now we're gonna install firmware file, allow, recent, but it's like messed up, so we go to downloads and here we install this one, 134 megabytes. Firmware successfully installed. Now install firmware file once again. Now we install this 56 megabytes. Firmware version 3.73. Okay. Next. Next once again. You have now completed initial setup. Your Vita3k system is ready. Great. Now we untick show next time because we don't want to see this next time. If you're interested, you can click any link. There is Discord, GitHub, Homebrew compatibility list, and that's pretty much it. So close. Now we create new user, user one, just put Z, that's it, confirm, okay. You wanna tick automatic user login, you know, so it automatically logs you in and you're gonna be greeted with this screen. So now we're in the emulator. All the options are on the top. They are not easy as press, especially if you have like this edge display like I have. It's right on the corner. Here is about. Here, if you go to controls, overlay, show gamepad overlay in game. If you want to play it without the controller, I wouldn't recommend that. I would recommend playing with the controller. Here you can click modify gamepad overlay. You can like move everything, whatever you want, however you want. You click reset to go back. Now you click X to get rid of this. And then you can go to controllers. No compatible controllers connected, so now we're gonna connect controller. I have this Razer Kishi, so we're gonna connect it. It didn't register it, because we need to close it. and open again, I believe. Now we go to controls, controllers, and as you can see, it shows up Razer Kishi. Let's try it out. It goes up and down. Now we go to configuration, settings, core automatic. I would leave everything like it is. Automatic CPU. There is not much to change. Default settings are best. Here in the GPU section, you can choose from Vulkan or OpenGL backend renderer. Here is a GPU. I cannot choose anything because there is no Snapdragon in this. I'll show you with the Snapdragon as well. Render accuracy standard. I will leave everything like it is. Here, this is interesting. Internal resolution upscaling. So you can go higher, 1.25, 1.5. Or you can also go down. If your phone is weak, you know, you can go 0.75 or even 0.5. That's the lowest right now. This is like PSP resolution, as you can see, 480 by 272. Native Vita is 960 by 544. But your phone should be able, depending on the specs, clearly 1.25, 1.5 should be okay. But I would recommend keeping it at 1x, because then you have highest compatibility. Here down at the bottom is FPS hack. This hack allows some games running at 30 to run at 60. For example, Uncharted Golden Abyss. On other games, it may have no effect or make them run twice as fast. Yeah, we can leave it on. I think this should be okay. But I'm leaving everything else at default. 1x, Mali G72. You click save, and then close. In the GPU, there is also texture replacement, import textures or export textures. In the debug, there is nothing interesting if you want to just play. Emulation, nothing. But here in the file, that's how we're going to install games. And we're going to be using this option, install.zip. Now how to install games. The official way is to take your physical game, physical cartridge, put it into your Vita and rip it. I'm legally obliged to tell you this way. If you can think of any other way, that's up to you. I'm telling you the official way. Once you have done it, your games folder is gonna look something like this. Some numbers and letters. And inside the folder is gonna look like this. This is a game in no NPDRM format. That's what you need. Once you have this game, you have to zip it. It needs to be zip, you know, .zip, not 7-zip or RAR, because I think those are not supported. So you're gonna zip this game on your phone or on your PC. You might even have it already zipped, depending on how you get the game. So this is my Vita3k folder on my hard drive with the games. It is all zip files, as you can see. Here are the sizes. So now I'm gonna move these three games from my hard drive to my phone. I'll wait until it's gonna copy over. Okay, we are back. I've copied all the games. I put it onto SD card. I created folder Vita3k. Here are three games that I copied over. Now we go back to Vita3k. We close this. Now we're gonna install the games in a Vita3k emulator. So we go to file, install zip, select file. Now we're gonna select the games. So we go to SD card, Vita3k. And now I'll go click on this one. And it's gonna install it. As you can see, Gravity Rush installing. We will wait until it's done. I think it's gonna take like 2-3 minutes, depending on the game. The larger, the longer. Okay, it's done. I think it took less than 2 minutes. As you can see now, we can play it. It's here, Gravity Rush, and it says it's a green icon, so that means it's compatible and should be fully playable. Then when you install the game, you click and hold onto it, and this menu will pop up. You can find a lot of interesting information in here, like, you know, all of the details of the game. Here you can also delete the game. You press delete and then you can delete application license or save data. You can also create shortcut. You click create shortcut. And as you can see, it will add shortcut of this game to your home screen. Let's press add. And here is Gravity Rush Vita3k. So when you press it, you don't need to launch Vita3k emulator once again and choose the game, but you go straight into it. Then, very important, you can also create custom configuration for the game. Create, and here you can create, you know, whatever configuration you would like. You can change CPU or GPU, you know, any setting, and save it. And it will be only saved for this specific game. You know, every game is different, so this is a very useful feature. because one game under certain configuration can crash, but the other works absolutely fine. Then we have here also compatibility. You can see playable here. When you click on open state report, it will go to the official Vita3k GitHub, to the issues where everybody were writing the best configuration for the selected game. However, majority of posts, as you can see, are from the PC version of the game, not really from the Android. So let's go to the bottom. So we are at the very bottom. Here are some latest from February 9th, and it's for the Steam Deck. There is not much related to the Android, or there, you know, it doesn't differ. It's everything is under here. So maybe if the game is not going to be working, you can just Google it and see what the results are going to pop up. Because, for example, this game shows up as compatible, but when I press it, it just crashes. You see, it just crashes. However, on this machine, as you can see, it's the exactly same version of the game. And when I press it, when I launch it, it just launches normally. When I go into settings, we can check the settings, compare them. Here I'm comparing settings. Everything is set pretty much on the same thing. CPU dynamic, enable optimizations. Backend renderer Vulkan, it has different GPU. This is G72, this is G52. Render accuracy high. 1x upscaling, 1x anisotropic, nothing checked. Here also nothing. This is even older version of Vita3k. But still, when I launch this game and this game, you see, this just crashed and this works fine. No idea why. Well, I have idea. Most likely it is caused by the chip. This one is Note 9 with Exynos 9, 6 gigs of RAM, but still, like, you know, it's quite good phone, but as you can see, it just crashes and there is not much you can do. In the settings, there is nothing you can really change. You know, I can change OpenGL, but I already tried it. It doesn't work. It doesn't crash, but it's like just black, you know. You can hear the audio, but it's just black. And then, you know what, I can untick this. Check the box to enable shader cache to precompile. It's gonna uncheck to disable this feature. Okay, uncheck. We'll uncheck it. Here I can hear already the game has launched, but there is nothing on the screen. That means, you know, I won't be able to play it. And this is case also for other games that I have installed. They just don't work because this freaking Exynos is not good for emulation, I would guess. This one also crashed, no idea why, but all of these games are working on this device absolutely fine. Here it works, and for whatever reason on the Exynos it doesn't work. The front touchscreen is automatically mapped on the touchscreen, so you can just tap and it's registered as input. You can normally click the screen like on the Vita and the inputs are gonna be registered. You can even play games with the rear touchpad, but you gotta, you know, change it with front, so you cannot play with both. Here is some Wipeout gameplay. Yeah, it runs quite good even on this weaker chip. To avoid these compatibility issues, ideally you want to use some Snapdragon chipset like this one. This is Odin 2 with Snapdragon Agent 2. Here, when you have Snapdragon in the settings, you can easily, in under GPU, choose custom driver for your GPU. There is always default one, and then you can download bunch of drivers like Turnip drivers, Adreno drivers. You can download every driver, even the latest one, from the this GitHub page. I will leave link for it down below. Here there are a bunch of Turnip drivers latest. Not all of them are compatible with your chip, so you gotta always read the description. You have to be aware what kind of GPU do you have. Here is Adreno 740. And here, for example, this Turnip driver, A730 variant support, fixes the crashes, 8 plus Gen 1, we're having troubles, also supports but may contain bugs. This one should be working. If you want to try it out, you click on assets, click on this one to download it, then you will download it, then you will go back to Vita3k. Here you will click add custom driver. And here this is your downloads folder. You will find it wherever you download it. Here, the regular Turnip, you'll click on it and it will be added. And this is the ideal use case scenario, you know, these Snapdragon chips are the best, so ideally you want to use them, but if you don't have them, what can you do, you know, nothing. But you can always try some games, you know, plenty of games work even on this old device with this old chip, but they are still running relatively good on 1x resolution. Here I'm playing Soul Sacrifice, frame rate is full speed, 30. And this is with, I think, default custom driver. If you would play any Switch games through Yuzu or any other emulator, here is also GPU driver manager, and you can use the same exact custom drivers for your GPU, because both emulators use same drivers. I'm a big fan of this emulator because it allows people that do not own PS Vita to play Vita games, which is amazing. This experimental emulator is still work in progress, so the developers are still working on it. But even in this state, it's amazing what all it can do. You can play in higher resolution than on Vita. You can use different textures, you know, HD textures or whatever. Some features are still not implemented, like fast forward or save states. But even without them, it's still a hell of a good emulator, in my opinion. I would like to dedicate one huge thanks to all you people that are working on this emulator and making it better. You are doing a great job. I would like to send also one huge thanks to all the channel members and Patreons for their continued support. It's greatly appreciated. I would like to thank you all for watching. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace! Small one, but yeah, I like it. Very nice. Four. Yeah, that was young deer. Yeah, I want to find one more. So I got a couple.